A resolution adopted by the Philippine House of Representatives urges the National Telecommunications Commission to suspend the operations of the Sunshine Media Network International. Meanwhile, an appeal is made with the Supreme Court for the release of two of the network's hosts who are detained at the lower chamber. Vivian Gulia reports.
The chairperson of the House Committee on Legislative Franchises visited on Monday the two hosts of Sunshine Media Network International detained at the House of Representatives. Paranaque 2nd District Representative Gus Tambunting says during his visit, Jeffrey K. Eric Celis disclosed the name of his source of erroneous information on House Speaker Martin Romualdez's alleged travel expenses. But this has to be validated first. Celis was cited in contempt and detained last Tuesday for refusing to divulge his source. During Monday's House panel inquiry, a letter appealing for reconsideration of Celis's detention order was read. Celis's legal counsel confirmed that it was written by his client. In the letter, the SMNI host apologized for his misbehavior and for failing to vet information from his source before making it public. While discussing the matter, the committee learned that the wife of Celis and the husband of fellow SMNI host Lorraine Badoy asked the Supreme Court on Monday to order their release from detention. They filed petitions for certiorari and habeas corpus against the House panel.
Gusto namin, kasama namin yung aming mga asawa. So, hopefully, pakinggan kami ng Supreme Court.
Sana po makamit namin ng justice. Mapakawalan si Ka Eric at si Ma'am Lorraine.
This prompted the committee to suspend consideration of Celis's request.
This is show of, how do you say it, bad faith. Makikiusap ka dito na humihingi ka ng pagpapalaya. Kasan sa likuran namin, kakasuhan nyo naman kami sa ibang sa Korte Suprema.
If they will not be able to withdraw, Mr. Chair, then we would like to let them know that they're going to stay here in this Christmas season.
The House of Representatives adopted on Monday a resolution urging the National Telecommunications Commission to suspend the operations of Suarezug Media Corporation or Sunshine Media Network International over alleged violations of their franchise. The adoption came hours after the House Committee on Legislative Franchises approved the committee report for House Resolution 1499. During Monday's panel hearing, PBA party list representative Margarita Nograles said SMNI violated sections 4, 10, and 11 of the Republic Act 11422. These pertains to the franchise holder's responsibility to the public to seek prior approval from Congress and report should there be transfer of controlling interest.
We are simply really urging NTC na mukhang nagkakalokohan dito kasi may mga fraudulent aspects dito. Suspindihin nyo muna habang tinitingnan natin lahat po.
The NTC, for its part, committed to evaluate the resolution carefully. SMNI previously denied violating its franchise. Lawmakers also questioned SMNI's planned collaboration with China Global Television Network amid rising tensions between the Philippines and China in the West Philippine Sea. But SMNI said that collaboration has yet to be finalized.
This is very dangerous, no? Kung ang isang franchise holder ay may cooperation o collab with the Chinese government, state-owned o pag-aari ng gobyerno ng China na media network.
Kung mayroon po silang video footage na gusto namin na gamitin sa aming balita, ay pwede po namin gamitin at hindi po nila kami pwedeng diktahan kung anong balita ang aming ipapalabas.
Religious leader Pastor Apollo Quiboloy skipped Monday's hearing, saying that he has not been an officer of Suarezug Media Corporation from the time of enactment of RA 11422 in 2019 up to the present. But Marikina 2nd District Representative Stella Kimbo asserted that documents submitted to the House of Representatives show that Quiboloy was the ultimate beneficial owner since SMNI's franchise was renewed in 2019 until 2021.
Parang mini-mislead yata tayo ng sulat na to. Based on our records, as of 2021, he was listed as ultimate beneficial owner. Ultimate beneficial owner means that he effectively controls a corporation.
Records from the Securities and Exchange Commission, however, show that Quiboloy was SMNI's ultimate beneficial owner until 2020. Kiba noted that there are discrepancies in the documents submitted to the SEC and the lower house.
So fake ho yun nandito?
Hindi man fake ho. Maybe nagkamali yung nag-file.
The panel will re-invite Kibuloy in the next hearing. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.